Gravitational waves are quite literally ripples in the fabric of our universe. The key to detecting gravitational waves is to be able to measure very, very small changes in the distance between objects. The way advanced LIGO does that is to build very large vacuum tubes with two orthogonal arms that are each 4 kilometers long. It shines a laser down each one of these arms at exactly the same time. The laser goes down each arm, bounces off of mirrors at each end, and then comes back. If during that time something has caused the length of one of those arms to change, then we'll be able to see that the laser light arrives slightly earlier or slightly later because the distance in one of the arms has changed. And the effect of a passing gravitational wave as it travels down through LIGO is to actually stretch one of the arms while simultaneously squeezing the other arm. So we end up seeing that there is actually a difference in the relative length of each of LIGO's arms. The gravitational waves that are passing through the Earth now that we may hope to detect are stretching and squeezing the Milky Way galaxy, the galaxy that we're in, by something that's about the width of our thumb. So you imagine taking the entire Milky Way galaxy and just squeezing it just the width of your thumb, and that's what we're trying to detect. LIGO actually operates two facilities, and one of them is in Washington State, and one of them is in Louisiana. They're about 3,000 kilometers apart, almost exactly. And the reason why we have two observatories is because it is so incredibly difficult to measure the very, very, very small change introduced by a gravitational wave that we really need to be sure. When a gravitational wave arrives at Earth, we expect any gravitational wave detector on Earth almost to be able to be sensitive to that source. And so by having two LIGO detectors spread across a great distance, if we observe a gravitational wave simultaneously in both, then we know that we have more confidence that it's in fact caused by a distant astrophysical process rather than just being caused by local noise, which we would expect not to be correlated between the two detectors. Observations with LIGO will basically open a completely new window on the universe. I don't think the average person stops to think too much about what space and time are, but when we tell them that we're absolutely sure that the space around them everywhere is wiggling about because somewhere distant in our universe a black hole has merged, I think that will send a pretty profound message to hopefully everyone about just how cool of a place our universe is.